Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening to everyone present on that side. I again welcome everyone present on that side on the Life Physics VK channel. So here we are again present to continue our class 12 topic that we were dealing, and that topic that we were dealing in the previously was electric potential. So up to now what we have studied was that we discuss about the electric potential. We discuss about the electric potential difference. We find out the formula for the electric potential due to the point charge, and that potential formula was, if you remember, it was 1 by 4 pi efficient naught q by r, which is also equal to work done per unit test charge. So this is the expression that we have already derived. Then we study about the potential difference. That means the amount of work done to move a test charge from one point to another point within the electric field, and the expression was again work done per unit test charge, which is numerically also equal to 1 by 4 pi efficient naught q 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2, the expression that we taught or that we study about. Okay, after this we again study about the electric dipole, means the pair of equal and opposite charges. And when we study about those, means pair of equal and opposite charges, so we find out or we try to find out the electric potential at the two different locations of the electric dipole, and these two different locations are along axial line and as well as along equatorial line. So we have studied that the electric potential along the axial line, it was 1 by 4 pi efficient naught p by x square for short dipole I am talking about, and the electric potential along the equatorial line. But at the end of the previous lecture, this expression was given or was provided as a homework, means the electric potential along the equatorial line you have to do by your own self, and I hope most of you and all of you have done this expression by your own, and your final result should be 0. Means the electric potential due to electric dipole along equatorial line is always 0. So these are the four points that we have studied up to now. Now we are going to continue more concept regarding the electric potential, and for today's lecture the thing that we are going to start is the important relation between your electric field and electric potential. So this is your important relation that we are going to study now. So what we are going to do here, we are going to find out a required relation between electric field and electric potential. So this expression is not that much lengthy, so all the components related to this expression you will find that, sir, these we have studied already. तो हम लोगों ने उन्हें कभी ना कभी देखा हुआ है. सो नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दैट. सो लेट्स सपोज वी हैव आवर सोर्स चार्ज व्हिच इज पॉजिटिव इन नेचर, एंड विद दैट सोर्स चार्ज वी हैव इट्स ओन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. इनसाइड और विद इन दैट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड वी हैव अ पॉइंट ए, एंड एट द पॉइंट ए व्हाट वी हैव अ टेस्ट चार्ज. सो एट अ पॉइंट ए वी हैव अ टेस्ट चार्ज क्यू नॉट. So what is going to be happen with the test charge? So test charge is being placed within the electric field. So you can note it down that let us consider a source charge plus Q. Source charge plus Q and a test charge Q naught is placed within the electric field. So this is being placed within the electric field. Okay, So this test charge is inside the electric field. So what is going to be happen? So check this out. We have a source charge which is positive in nature. We have a test charge which is also being a positive in nature always. It is your standard. So since both are positive in nature, what is going to be happen? That this test charge is going to experience a repulsive force. So here we are going to do that. Force acting on test charge. So we all know that what is the formula for the force? F is equal to Q into E. So what is the force experience? F is equal to Q into E. The expression that we derived in the first lecture of the electric field, that force is always equal to Q into E, means from the definition of the electric field, E is equal to force experience per unit test charge. So from that we have the force experience on that charge, and since it is repulsive in nature, so this would be the direction of the force. Then so because of that force, so this is the force which is acting on the A point, means the force which is acting on the test. So this test charge is under the force, and let's suppose we want to displace this test charge from A to B, and that displacement is delta R. So delta R is the displacement beam that we want to do of about the test charge from A to B, but that test charge is under a electrical force which is acting in outward direction, or you can say on right hand side, because there is a repulsive behavior. So thus the work done on the test charge is equal to force vector dot displacement vector. And since you can check this out, that since the force vector is acting on the right hand side, so the displacement is acting on the left hand side. So we want to move from A to B. So the angle between force and displacement is 180 degrees. And when you remove the dot product, it would be F into dr into cos 180. And what is your small work then? It would be negative F dr, where negative sign implies that we are working against the electrical force. हम लोग electrical force के against work कर रहे हैं. But we have an expression for the force. So what is that expression? That, or we can say dW is equal to negative Q naught E dr. So this is our, what you can say, the small amount of work that we are doing. But since we know that what is potential difference? Potential difference. Why I use the word potential difference? Because here we are moving the test charge from one point to another point. But both the points, means point A and point B, both are within the electric field. And if it is so, we know that what is the formula for potential difference? Work done per unit test charge. This is the expression that we have done already in the previous lecture. So from here, what is the work done? Potential difference into Q naught. So we have two small amount of work done that we have. Number one, means equation number two, but this work done in terms of the electric field. Equation number three, it also represents, or it also gives the information about the small work done, or you can say the work done in terms of that small potential difference. So since by comparing 2 and 3, what we got? We got is that negative Q naught E dr, means delta R, is equal to delta V, or you can say dV into Q naught. Q naught cancel with the Q naught, and what is the E that we got? Negative delta V by delta. And here we have a relation between what and what? We have a relation between electric field and electric potential difference. Okay, so here we have a relation between electric field and electric potential difference at the finally. and that relation is electric field is always equal to negative of delta V by delta R. Means electric field is equal to negative of potential difference divided by the separation, the displacement, whatever be the thing that you want to call this. And that is an important relation. Why it has been important? Because as I discussed, as I told you, that all the concepts that we discuss here itself in the classroom, means we are doing right now, all these concepts are the only thing which are the majority part of any competition exam. Majority part means you can say your 80 to 85% of the content is always from your board, whatever be the thing that we are dealing in the board itself. So this classroom is your board. This classroom is your NEET, and this classroom is itself is your JEE Main. Yahi hamara sab kuch hai, CBSE, NEET, JEE Main, everything. You can try by your own. Just we have to do the practice alone. So initially, from the previous lecture, we were dealing on the concepts. So first of all, try to clear the concept. Try to solve the numericals of NCERT under. And in slowly, slowly, we will raise our level. And you will get the assignment as soon as this electrostatics is going to finish. You will get the assignment related to all the competition exam. बीच में मैंने आपको कभी नहीं बोला कि दिस इज द कॉम्पिटिशन. वी आर डूइंग ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ बोर्ड, एंड बोर्ड का बेसिक ही आपको सब कुछ क्लियर कर देगा, योर एनसीईआरटी इटसेल्फ. सो हियर द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज इक्वल टू नेगेटिव डीवी बाय डीआर. सो व्हाट इज ई स्टैंड्स फॉर, यू नो दैट, बट हियर आई वांट टू क्लियरिफाई दिस वर्ड. एंड व्हाट इज दैट वर्ड, डीवी बाय डीआर मीन चेंज इन पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस बाय चेंज इन सेपरेशन. दिस टर्म is on a single manner, it is called as potential gradient. What is called potential gradient? Or you can also define that electric field is always equal to negative of potential difference. Electric field is always been equal to negative of potential gradient, or you can say negative of change in potential divided by the change in separation. But here we have the negative sign, and this negative sign implies something, and this is your, you can say, the most important note jo aapko bahut cheezon mein help karega, and that note is negative sign implies that in the direction of electric field, potential decreases. Yes, this is the thing that you have to learn, that in the direction of electric field, potential decreases. Since this is your positive source charge, this is your test charge. So in on the right hand side, this test charge experiences the force, we all know that. But now if I ask you, what is the direction of electric field, you will say that, sir, the direction of electric field is from positive to negative, means outward for the positive and inward for the negative. Now I am again asking, why you are saying that outward for the positive and inward for negative? And the concept is, we have discussed, जब हम लोगों ने इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइन्स का डायरेक्शन का डिस्कशन किया था, सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड डायरेक्शन इज ऑलवेज बीइंग रिप्रेजेंटेड अलोंग द लाइन ऑफ फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस बाय द टेस्ट चार्ज. मींस द लाइन अलोंग विच द टेस्ट चार्ज इज एक्सपीरियंसिंग द फोर्स बिकॉज ऑफ सोर्स चार्ज, दैट लाइन ऑफ फोर्स इज इटसेल्फ कॉल्ड एज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड डायरेक्शन. And this test charge is experiencing the, how much? In outward direction, or you can say on the right hand side. So what would be the direction of electric field of the source charge? That would be also in this manner. This is the electric field of source charge. What is F? It is the force experienced by the test charge because of the source charge. So you have to be clear. it is belong to that, but this is acting on this, but because of that. So this is the thing that you have to clearly understand. And this negative sign implies that in the direction of electric field, potential always decreases. Means electric field ka direction mein jaise jaise hum jaate jayenge, potential kam hota jayega. So if I ask you, there are two points in the electric field, point A and point B. So which point is at higher potential? If I ask you, dono mein se kaun se point ka potential jyada hoga? Whether A or whether B? And the answer is B. Because B is more closer to the plus Q point. That is the one reason. But you can also understand by this line. And this line is very much important and it will help you a lot to solve various numerical. And the line is, in the direction of electric field, potential decreases. Electric field ka direction mein potential hamesha kam hota hai. और इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड का डायरेक्शन है राइट हैंड साइड. मीन जैसे जैसे राइट हैंड साइड में जाते जाएंगे पोटेंशियल कम होता जाएगा. तो इसका मतलब ए इज लेस एज कंपैरिजन टू बी. एंड इफ इट इज नेगेटिव चार्ज, अगर ये सोर्स चार्ज नेगेटिव होता तो व्हाट वुड बी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड? इनवर्ड. देन यू विल से इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड पोटेंशियल डिक्रीजेस. सो अगर आपका इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लेफ्ट हैंड साइड है तो पोटेंशियल कम होता जाएगा. सो इट मीन्स ए हैज अ हायर पोटेंशियल. And with that logic, there is one conceptual question जो बहुत बार board में देखा गया है. We will discuss just after it. But before that, please note it down the relation between electric field and electric potential difference. And please also note this important note that in the direction of electric field, potential decreases. Please have it. Okay, everyone. Let's start have or let's discuss some numerical related to the electric potential that we have studied the topic recently. Means the relation between electric field and the potential difference. So the relation that we derived recently, first of all I want to clarify that relation again. Please try to understand that relation again. E is equal to negative dV by dr. And that is my personal request that you will again note it down everything. What is E stands for? You all know that. Sir, E stands for electric field. What is delta V stands for? It stands for potential difference. And what is delta R stands for? The separation between the two points. Mean this dr or delta R was the distance between point A and point B. But that distance means the perpendicular distance, I want to clarify, between two points along electric field vector. Means is that, what is delta R represents here? There is, in the previous diagram that we discussed, there was a point A and there was a point B. So this delta R is the distance between both the point. But that distance between both the point is along the electric field. Means along the line of the electric field. Whether your electric field is acting outward or whether your electric field is acting inward. That delta R is the distance between both the point in the same line. Or you can say this is the perpendicular distance between both the axes. पॉइंट ए पॉइंट बी और दोनों के बीच के परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस को ही हम लोग डेल्टा आर बताएंगे. सो दिस पॉइंट दैट व्हाट इज द डेल्टा आर, एवरीवन नो दैट इट इज द सेपरेशन. बट अलोंग विच एक्सिस एंड हाउ दैट सेपरेशन इट इज बीइंग बिटवीन द टू पॉइंट, ये क्लेरिफाई होना बहुत जरूरी है. एंड दैट डेल्टा आर इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू पॉइंट्स अलोंग द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. यू शुड नो दैट. ओके, what does that negative sign implies? ये भी आप लोग जानते हैं. That in the direction of electric field potential decreases. One more thing जो मैं आपसे चाहता हूँ कि हम लोग पीछे जाके लिखें, क्योंकि कई बार हम लोग इस चीज को कर लेते हैं. So will you help me out in SI unit of, please will you please help me out in the SI unit of electric field? Electric field SI unit. Okay, wait for some time. इन यूनिट्स के बारे में जस्ट आफ्टर द न्यूमेरिकल डिस्कस करते हैं, वी विल पॉज इट आउट, अब तक रुकते हैं, डू नॉट मेक कंफ्यूजन. सो बैक टू द न्यूमेरिकल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल पहले ये करते हैं, जस्ट आफ्टर द न्यूमेरिकल वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द यूनिट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द न्यूमेरिकल, एज शोन इन द फिगर, व्हाट वुड बी द साइन ऑफ VA माइनस VB, दैट व्हाट वुड बी द साइन ऑफ पोटेंशियल ऑफ A माइनस पोटेंशियल ऑफ B. When we go potential of A minus potential of B, what would be the sign? Whether it is positive, whether it would be negative, or whether it would be zero. That means the potential difference between A or B, positive, negative, or zero. You have to give the answer. So here you have the diagram. You have the plus Q charge, source charge. This is point A and this is point B. So recently, since we know that, what we know? That E is equal to negative dV by dr. What does it mean? It means in the direction of electric field, in the direction of electric field, potential decreases. And this line would be repeatedly, and you have to say it again and again like the mantra. जैसे मंत्र का जाप करते हैं ना, ओम ओम नमः शिवाय, and जो भी आप लोग XYZ करते हैं, you have to repeat this again and again like the same mantra. In the direction of electric field potential decreases. In the direction. And जैसे मैं आपको हमेशा बोलता रहता हूँ, just roam at your home. आपने अपने घर में roam कीजिए, घूमिए. अपने घर में घूमते रहिए, घूमते घूमते बोलते रहिए अपने मॉम को डैड को. सारे अभी लॉकडाउन है तो सारे अवेलेबल है. ओके मॉम, इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड पोटेंशियल डिक्रीजेस. डैड को बोलो, ब्रदर को बोलो, इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड पोटेंशियल डिक्रीजेस. दैट वुड बी अ प्रीटी मच हैबिचुअल पार्ट, बिकॉज हमारे माइंड का प्रोसेस ये है कि जब हम लोग किसी चीज को बार बार रिपीट करते हैं ना, दैट वुड बी कीप इन द माइंड फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम पीरियड, और हमेशा के लिए आपके दिमाग में. मैं ये नहीं कर रहा ये रटना है, बट आपको फ्रीक्वेंटली बोलना, ये नहीं लगातार है. आपने अभी बोला, थोड़ी देर के बाद बोला, फिर ऐसे रिपीट योर सेल्फ. ओके, सो इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड पोटेंशियल डिक्रीजेस मींस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड का डायरेक्शन में पोटेंशियल कम होगा. सो दिस इज पॉजिटिव चार्ज, सो वेयर वुड बी द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड? सपोज द पॉजिटिव, द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज आउटवर्ड. सो इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड पोटेंशियल डिक्रीजेस. सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन में जैसे जैसे जाएंगे पोटेंशियल कम होता जाएगा, तो कम किसका होगा? B. So it implies that potential of B is less than potential of A. In the direction of electric field, potential decreases. Means electric field का direction में potential कम होगा. इसका मतलब B का potential A से कम है, क्योंकि electric field की direction में चल रहे हैं. If B is less than A, and what we have to find out? VA minus VB. So B is less than A, or you can say A is greater than B. And if A is greater than B, so you are subtracting greater minus smaller. इसका मतलब आप heavy यानी ज़्यादा number में से greater number में से small को minus कर रहे हैं. So greater minus smaller gives you the sign of positive. So thus VA minus VB would be positive in nature. This is your the one marks numerical or one marks conceptual question जो हमसे पूछा जा सकता है. Clear? So in the direction of electric field, potential decreases. So you can do that. Okay. Now I can reverse the question by using the negative sign. मैं यहाँ पे negative sign use कर सकता हूँ. I can ask what is the VB minus VA. So this is the small modification that we can make about this numerical. Now after this, let's come to the second numerical that is in front of you again on this side. Okay. So in this numerical, what is given to us? Try to understand. He says three points. A, B and C in uniform electric field. So we have a uniform electric field, and you know that uniform electric field is always represented by the parallel lines of 5 into 10 power 3 Newton per coulomb. So electric field is given to us. So the value of electric field is 5 into 10 power 3 Newton per coulomb. So this is the uniform electric field, means it is same at all point, point A, point B, point C. Whichever be the point that you want to study or you have asked to study, आपसे पूछा गया कि आपको वो पढ़ना है, that electric field would be same at all the points as shown in the figure. Now, what is the first thing he is asking? find the potential difference between A and C. So you have to find the potential difference between A and C. So since teacher or the examiner or the question has given you the electric field and he is asking for potential difference. So आपको electric field दिया है और potential difference के बारे में पूछा गया है. So there is only one single relation between electric field and potential difference. केवल एक ही relation है, that E is equal to negative dV by dr, where negative sign implies that thing. So if negative implies something, so let's work on the magnitude first of all. So since magnitude E is equal to dV by dr, so here presently we are walking or we are talking about magnitude V. Potential difference positive आएगा या negative आएगा, means VA minus VB, that is the different thing. So E is equal to delta V by delta R, और here delta V is equal to E into delta. Clear? So delta V means potential difference is equal to E into delta. So electric field we have, but delta R stands for what? The perpendicular distance between the two points along the electric field. Please, this is the definition of your delta R. The distance between the two points along the axis or along the line of the electric field. And here are the two points. वो दो points जो हमसे पूछे गए हैं, that we have to find out. We have to find out the potential difference between A and C. A और C के बीच में हमें वो distance निकालना है. Means we have to find out the potential difference between A and C. So it means we required the delta R of which point? AC. हमें A और C का separation चाहिए. But separation should be clear in your mind that what type of I'm separation talking about? The perpendicular separation between both the points along the direction of electric field. So now this is A, this is B, this is C. So ये आपका A point है. This is your C point. We have to find out the separation. But what type of separation? I am again mentioning the perpendicular separation along the electric field. वो perpendicular distance दोनों point में जो electric field के साथ चल रहा है. साथ का मतलब ये नहीं कि उसी के axis में हो, but means on the same line हो. So this is A point and this is the C point. So what is that type of separation? तो इस dr को कौन define कर रहा है? Is that 5 cm? No. Okay, 5 cm, it is the distance between A and C. वो A और C के बीच का distance है. But it is not that perpendicular distance between A and C. ये A और C. Then let's suppose this is A, this is C. It is not that perpendicular distance और ये electric field के along भी नहीं. So what is that perpendicular distance which is acting along that? And that distance is this one. This AB. So first of all, by Pythagoras theorem, so by Pythagoras theorem, your AB would be, I think, 4 cm. This AB would be how much? 4 cm. 3 square, 5 square minus 3 square, it will give you 16. And the square root of the 16 would be the 4 cm. And this AB is representing you the perpendicular distance. Wo AB aapko perpendicular distance de raha hai, A or C ke beech mein. If you try to point out. इन दोनों के बीच का परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस यहां पे होगा. सो दैट डिस्टेंस वुड बी द 4 सेंटीमीटर. सो व्हाट वुड बी डेल्टा वी? इट वुड बी 5 × 10³ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड दैट सेपरेशन इज 4 सेंटीमीटर. लेट अस कन्वर्ट इनटू द मीटर. सो इट वुड बी डेल्टा वी वुड बी 5 × 20 × 10 और डेल्टा वी इज इक्वल टू 200 एंड द SI यूनिट इज 4. So the potential difference between A and C point is 200 volt. So you can say potential difference between which point, if you want to specify, the potential difference between A and C is 200 volt. Clear? You have to be concerned about only one thing and that thing is delta R. The perpendicular distance, उन दो point के बीच का वो distance जो electric field की line में है. यहाँ पे आपको क्या दे रखा है? Means electric field यहाँ है, A point आपने यहाँ ले लिया, C point आपको नीचे दिया हुआ, so we do not require that distance, we require this distance, हमें ये distance चाहिए, the perpendicular distance, बिकॉज इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड जो भी होगा वो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन में होगा. इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड पोटेंशियल डिक्रीजेस, सो दैट वुड बी वर्क और गोइंग टू बी वर्क इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, मीन्स ऑन दैट एक्सिस. आपके इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड यहाँ जा रहा है, आप ये वाला सेपरेशन देख रहे हैं, सो दिस वुड नॉट बी द पार्ट ऑफ दैट. ओके, नाउ इफ आई आस्क यू वन थिंग हियर व्हिच हैजंट बीन आस्क्ड, बट इफ आई आस्क यू व्हाट इज दैट डेल्टा आर फॉर बी एंड सी, व्हाट इज डेल्टा आर फॉर बी एंड सी, बी और सी में वो डेल्टा आर कितना है, मीन्स द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस बिटवीन बी एंड सी बट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. प्लीज ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस बिटवीन बी एंड सी बट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन में चाहिए. सो दिस इज द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस बिटवीन बी एंड सी बट दिस डिस्टेंस इज नॉट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. तो बताइए इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन में इन दोनों के बीच का डिस्टेंस कितना है, जीरो. ये एग्जैक्ट यहां पे, सो दिस इज द बी पॉइंट एंड एग्जैक्टली दिस इज द सी पॉइंट. सो इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड दोनों के बीच में गैप कुछ नहीं है बिकॉज दे आर एग्जैक्टली वर्टिकली डाउनवर्ड, एक दूसरे के बिल्कुल नीचे. सो दैट डिस्टेंस इज जीरो एंड इफ डेल्टा आर इज जीरो सो व्हाट वुड बी द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस वुड बी जीरो. And if potential difference is zero, it means at both the point the potential is same. तो इस question से हमें ये चीज भी और सीखने को मिलता है कि B और C दोनों का ही potential same होगा. If I want to give you an extra knowledge, अगर आप जानना चाहते हैं, because दोनों के बीच का delta R है ही नहीं. Now in the second point, which point is at higher potential? इनमें से कौन सा पॉइंट हायर पोटेंशियल पे है? सो अलॉन्ग टू फाइंड आउट कि कौन सा हायर पे है, अगेन वी हैव टू डू दैट. दैट हियर द एग्जैक्ट फॉर्मूला इज नेगेटिव डेल्टा वी बाय डेल्टा आर, वेयर नेगेटिव साइन इंप्लाइज दैट इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड पोटेंशियल डिक्रीजेस. सो वेयर इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, टुवर्ड्स द राइट हैंड साइड. सो इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड पोटेंशियल डिक्रीजेस, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन में पोटेंशियल कम होगा. तो इसका मतलब कम किसका होगा, सी का. और सी और बी का पोटेंशियल सेम है तो दोनों ही कम है, तो हाइयर पोटेंशियल किसका हुआ, ए का. सो आवर बी पार्ट आंसर इज दैट वी ए इज हायर, और यू कैन से द ए पॉइंट इज एट हायर पोटेंशियल. सो हियर वी हैव दिस 3 मार्क्स न्यूमेरिकल जो हमसे बहुत बार पूछा गया है, बहुत बार 2009-12 और इसके अपार्ट भी एक दो बार और ईयर्स हैं जो मुझे अभी स्पेसिफाइड नहीं है, बट इट हैज बीन आस्क्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम. एंड द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच इज प्रिटी लॉजिकल कॉन्सेप्ट भी है. सो प्लीज बोथ द क्वेश्चंस नोटेड डाउन एंड ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट, मीन सिमिलरली लाइक असाइनमेंट में आपको मिल ही जाएगा, बट प्लीज गो विद दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. ओके, डन. नाउ Now we are going to continue again on the same concept, means we have derived only one relation, that E is equal to negative dV by dr, and this relation help us to solve one more logical question jo competitions mein dekha gaya hai. But before that let us try to have all the concepts jo ab tak hum logo ne isme se seekhe hain ek bar fir se. E is equal to negative dv by dr, this is called as potential gradient. Okay, so negative sign implies in the direction of electric field potential decreases. Now let's talk about the some more term jo maine aapse kaha tha that we will talk about the SI unit. So from here will you please just help me SI unit of electric field, isme help karenge aap please. So E is equal to negative implies कि potential कम होता जाएगा. So delta V potential difference volt and separation meter. So the new SI unit of electric field is volt per meter. और एक और जो हम लोगों ने पहले से सीख चुके हैं that is Newton per coulomb. So from today onwards you are going to get the new unit of the electric field. आपको इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड का एक और यूनिट आपसे देखने को मिलेगा एंड दैट यूनिट इज वोल्ट पर मीटर. ओके, इससे एक और चीज मेरे दिमाग में आता है, क्योंकि हम लोग बहुत बार इस चीज को आपसे ट्विस्ट कर देते हैं, दैट ऐसा यूनिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स, आई नो इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स फिनिश हो चुका है, नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइन पासिंग थ्रू द सरफेस नॉर्मली वो हम लोगों ने पहले पढ़ा था, बट आई वॉन्ट टू एड दिस, एंड वॉट वॉज द फॉर्मूला, वॉट वॉज द ऐसा यूनिट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स by this formula ea cos theta, you know that. So this was newton per coulomb meter square. So this was the SI unit of electric flux, because the SI unit of electric field was newton per coulomb. But now by relating this, by having this relation, we have a new SI unit of the electric field in terms of the potential. But so what would be the new unit of the electric flux if we use the potential term in terms of the electric flux? So phi would be E, volt per meter, and it would be meter square. So you have new unit of electric flux, volt meter. And this is the new thing. What is the SI unit of electric field? Volt per meter, volt per meter. And what is the new unit of electric flux? Voltmeter. And this is the minute difference जहाँ पे हम लोग हमेशा फंस जाते हैं. And there is a question जो आपसे बार-बार पूछा जाता है. Name the physical quantity. There is a question. If I ask you, अभी तो आप बता देंगे. And the question is, name the physical quantity. Name the physical quantity having SI unit voltmeter, whether it is scalar or vector. So one mark question जो हम लोग add कर सकते हैं. So name the physical quantity whose unit is voltmeter. So voltmeter SI unit is of flux, and whether it is scalar or vector, so electric flux is the number of electric field line, so it is a scalar quantity, definitely. But if we talk about the electric field, so if I say name the physical quantity having SI unit volt per meter, if I give a slash here, if I give a only slash here, everything changes. So the quantity which who's having the SI unit volt per meter, and whether it is scalar or vector, so you will say, sir, volt per meter is the SI unit of electric field, and electric field is vector quantity. So this is the minute thing jo main chahta hu ki aap log apne paas add kare, and you should note it down, these two terms on the upper margin, and go back to the electric field topic jahan pe aap electric field aapne pehli baar likha tha, जहां पे आप लोगों ने ऐसा यूनिट न्यूटन पर कूलम है, गो बैक देयर एंड वहां पे ब्रैकेट में वोल्ट पर मीटर मेंशन कीजिए. इन अ सिमिलर मैनर, गो बैक टू द इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स, मेंशन कीजिए वोल्ट मीटर इज द एसआई यूनिट एंड इट इज अ स्केलर क्वांटिटी बिकॉज इट इज द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइन, बट इट इज योर वेक्टर क्वांटिटी एंड इट्स डायरेक्शन इज नॉट पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव. सो दिस इज द न्यू वन मोर थिंग that we get to know from the electric flux, sorry, get to know from the relation between electric field and potential difference. Now next thing that I want to add, since E is equal to delta V by delta R, so magnitudely E is equal to dV by, or what would be dV, is equal to EVd. So we have potential difference E in V, d delta V is equal to E into delta R. So once if he ask us to calculate the potential, so what we have to do? We have to do the integration of delta V, and which is equal to the integration of E delta V. So sometimes, and the next question that we are going to discuss, that question might be asked, or that question has a solution is in this manner. So we are going to work on that. Okay, so please, first of all, you can say that we have a relation. What is that relation? Indicates that E is equal to negative of potential gradient, where negative sign implies that in the direction of electric field potential decreases. Delta R represents you the different thing, delta r shows the perpendicular distance between the two points in the direction or along the electric field. We get to know about the new SI units of electric field as well as electric flux. We can have such type of question also. And now we have in terms of the magnitude. Or if I say in terms of the magnitude, so if you try to apply the mathematical tool here, so how you can say that E is equal to delta V by delta R? But if you want to speak this relation in terms of mathematics, agar aap mathematics ki language mein bolna chahte hain, what you will try to say? Sir, electric field is equal to differentiation of potential with respect to the separation. Delta V by delta R means it is the differentiation of V with respect to R. Do that. Secondly, if we want to say the voltage, agar hame V nikalna hai, so V would be, it is the integration of V into delta. So this is the concept jo hum log ek hi relation se nikal sakte. So up to here, in this time period, we only derived the one relation, but that relation taught us the various things. Aur bahut alag cheeze kiya hai. And the one next numerical that we are going to work on that on a quick manner, but before that please note down this everything. Okay everyone, so here we have the most important numerical that has been asked in the competitions all the time, and this is the type of the question jo competition either JE Main or the PMT, all the three questions are the part of either PMT or the JE Main. So how to solve this question and what is this question is talking about, so you can check this out. If the potential in a region of a space around at a point, so we have a point and that point is given as -1, 2, 3. So at that point the potential is 10x square plus 5y square minus 3z square. So this is the potential at this point. So calculate the electric field at that point. So we have to find out the electric field at that point. Since you can check out that the potential here depend upon all the three axis component. It depend upon x, it depend upon y, and it depend upon z. It means the potential is varying or changing with respect to x axis also, with respect to y, and with respect to z. It means potential depend upon all the three components. And if it is so, if the potential depend upon all the three components, we have to get the electric field. We have to get the electric field in all the three components. So let's suppose and let's work on along x-axis. So we all know that generally E is equal to magnitude E dV by dr. So along the x-axis, it would be dV by dx. Okay, and I think we will do that. We will do this. So first of all, help me out. So this indicates the differentiation of V with respect to separation. But here that separation is varying in all the axes. Means what the separation means coordinates hai. These coordinates are the 3D coordinate -1, 2, and 3. Means it varies along the x as well as y as well as z. It means we are going to study all the components individually. हम लोग हर component को अलग-अलग study करेंगे. So for the x, please help me out. So the potential difference with respect to x. So differentiate V with respect to x. So when you differentiate it, it would be 20x. This would be 0. Y would be treated as 0 because we are differentiating with respect to x, and this would be also 0. So this is your electric field along the x-axis. Similarly, along y, if you have variation, so Ey would be dv by dy, and v with respect to y, when you solve it, it would be your 10y, because the rest of components are taken as the constant. So when you are differentiating with respect to x or y, means when you are dealing with one particular axis, the rest of the axis would be considered as a constant part. Similarly, along which axis? The last one is z axis. So Ez would be how much? dv by dz, and it will give you how much? -6z, because it is -3z squared. This would be 0, this would be 0, and this would be. So we have all the three components of the electric field. Electric field on x axis, y axis and z axis. So what would be your net electric field? It would be Ex I cap plus Ey j cap plus Ez k. Why I use the I j k? You are familiar that I cap, j cap and k cap are the unit vectors representing the x axis, y axis and z axis respectively. And here the electric field is vector quantity. So what would be your electric field? Please help me out. So our electric field would be 20x I cap plus 10y j cap minus 6z k. Now we have to find out what? We have to find out the electric field at that point. So that point word se wo kya signify kar raha hai? That we have to find out the electric field at negative 2 and 3. So thus E vector at negative 1, 2 and 3. So what would be the electric field? So x negative 1. So it would be negative 20 I cap plus 20 j cap minus 6 z, and z is 3. So negative 18 k cap Newton per coulomb. So this is the electric field at that point. And if you want to find out the magnitude of the electric field, you know that. How to calculate the magnitude? Under root x square plus y square plus, means we have to again go to the sum vector concept and the vector related parts jo hum log 11th mein deal kar chuke. So here we have one more type of the numerical which is related to E is equal to delta V by delta. So in a similar manner, do this first question, and these are the two questions that I am placing as your homework. So you will deal these two questions as your homework. So please note it down first here. Okay everyone, since we have discussed a lot about the relation between electric field and potential difference, and that small relation, so relation was just only, you can say, the small relation, the derivation was not that much lengthy, but that relation taught us and it will teaches us various things, various new things, various different types of numerical proofs. And at the end of this lecture, not taking that much time, we are going to discuss one more derivation, or you can say one more topic, and that topic is electric potential due to spherical body. So similarly, we have studied the electric field due to the spherical body. In a same manner, we are going to study the electric field, electric potential due to the spherical body. So check this out. So let's suppose we have a spherical body of radius capital R having charge plus Q, which is being uniformly distributed all over the surface. You know that whenever any charge is given to the body, that charge is always uniformly distributed all over the surface. So here we have a P point. The P point which is at a distance of small r. So this P point is at a distance of small r from the center of the spherical body, and we have to study that point in all the cases. So the diagram and the concept till now I think is a simple, and that is, let us consider a spherical body of radius capital R having charge plus Q. Okay, a P point is considered at a distance of small r from where? From the center of body. So this is the assumption that we are taking in the diagram. So let us find out the potential. But in the similar manner, like we try to find out the electric field due to spherical body. And if you know that, in that numerical or in that derivation, we try to find out the electric potential at three possible cases. Possible case number one is outside the body. Outside word means when small r is greater than capital R. So since the potential is, what is the formula for the potential we have? It is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught amount of charge q divided by, what is the separation of the p point from the center? It is the small r. So here the electric potential due to that spherical body, but when the p point is out of that spherical body. So here we have the relation, simple. Similar, second, on the surface, you can say when your p point is on the surface of that spherical body, so what would be the potential here, please? So the potential would be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q, and when your p point would be on the surface, in that case your small r is equal to capital R, and we would have the relation in this manner. In a similar manner, the third possible case, and that would be inside, when small r is less than capital R. So we have to be concerned about this case, because this case gives you a different concept. What is that concept? Please try to understand. Inside. So P point, when it was outside, we have potential, because outside the P point means outside the spherical body, we have the electric field. Secondly, on the surface. So on the surface also we have the electric field. But now we are inside the P point, inside that spherical body. And we all know that what is the electric field inside any body is zero. So inside any body, the electric field is always zero. Why? Because it does not encloses any charge, according to that previous concept. So inside, if the electric field is zero, so since we know that E is equal to dV by dr, but since inside electric field is zero, so dV by dr is zero. It means the differentiation of potential with respect to separation is zero. And you all are familiar that which term has the zero differentiation, or under what condition any term can have the zero differentiation, and that condition is when V is constant, when it is not variable, and it would be equal to the potential at surface. So what we got here, that inside the spherical body, inside the spherical body, the potential, electric potential, is always constant, and which is always equal to the potential at the surface. Means agar aapki body ke surface pe potential 10 volt hai, to andar bhi kitna hoga? 10 volt. But under electric field kitna hoga? 0. That is the new thing jo hamare liye sabse important bhi banta hai, aur jo hamare liye working bhi. So here we have the electric potential due to spherical body, and we have the potential in all the three possible cases. Har possible cases mein hamare paas hai. Now we are going to do the last thing. What? We are plot the graph of that potential. So let's suppose I am writing the P point here to indicate the R. So now, so finally, what? The variation of V versus R, the separation case. So what we get to know, that inside, let's suppose this is your spherical body. So for this spherical body, inside the potential is always constant. So from here to here means up to you are not reaching up to the surface. Jab tak aap surface pe nahi pahunchte hain, till then your potential is constant. So the potential is constant jab tak hum log andar hai. Whatever be the value of that potential, it will remain the constant. and that potential would be equal to whatever be the potential on the surface. So means you can say inside the potential is always equal to 1 by 4 pi efficient naught q by capital R. So whatever be the potential on the surface, same potential would be on the, it would be inside the body. Now outside, how the outside potential relate with the R? Inversely, and it will go little bit in the curve manner. And that is the variation of V versus R. The second important variation. The first variation that we study in the electric field due to the spherical body, E versus R. That inside it was zero, surface, and then we have inversely proportional. Now we have the V versus R. Okay, in the class 11th, if I recall, there was acceleration due to gravity versus the radius of the body. So you can say that versus separation, we have three graphs till now. If you are looking for the competition, to be a graph mix hote hain. So it was G versus R, acceleration due to gravity versus separation. You can recall it, please. We have studied in the gravitation chapter. Now we have studied E versus R, electric field versus R. And now we have recently studied electric potential versus R. So G versus R, E versus R, and V versus R, electric potential versus R. And in future, we are going to study about the B versus R. B means magnetic field versus separation. So means versus R, char graph bande. Or previous to previous year in the NEET 2018, this was asked. They have given us all the four particular graph and they ask for the one relevant graph. What will be the variation of electric field? Either potential ko unme se kuch bhi pooch sakta. So that's why you have to be concerned. And this is the final topic of today's lecture. So we have potential outside q by r on the surface, and inside the potential is always constant. Now, before leaving or before finishing, the one question that I want to arise, or a question jo main aapse puchna chahta hu, can you explain me, seedha sa baat hai, can you explain me a certain condition in which electric field is zero but potential is non-zero? Any condition where the electric field is zero but potential is not zero. This is your first. Any second condition where potential is zero but electric field is not zero. So till now, whatever be the concept, jo bhi hum logon ne electrostatics mein padha hai, please let me know the answer for that. Any point or any condition where electric field is zero but potential is not zero. I am writing little bit here, you can note it down. Any point where E is 0 but V is not 0. This is your first point. Second, where E is not 0 but V is 0. You have to give me that point. So give me the two conditions jahan pe ye dono cheeze work karti ho. Kya aisa kuch possible hai? Or if I ask, definitely aisa hai. So you have to give me the answer. So I am waiting for the answer. And now at the end, you will get your assignment related to all the topic that we discuss in the potential. Okay, so after this, means after uploading this video, you will have a one day proper gap, and in that one day proper gap you have to complete that assignment. So one day to look over or go through this lecture, and one day to complete your assignment. So please note it down, this last topic. I am waiting for this answer, and complete your assignment. Thank you very much. Please note it down.